Hey everyone, it's Carrie here. I'm here to talk to you today about community onboarding. Now, you've probably heard before that onboarding new members into a community is a critical part of any community member journey. And what people mean when they say that is that really first impressions are everything. Just like when you meet someone, your first impression of them oftentimes dictates how you feel about them moving forward, your first impression of a community also matters very, very deeply and can impact how you think about that community going forward. So for those of us who build communities for our clients, for our communities that we care about personally, it's really, really important that we get that first impression right. So what I'm talking about in this video is how to do that systematically, not just say you need good onboarding, but actually give you a framework through which you can actually plan out thoughtful onboarding for your community. So let's get into it. Now, what you're seeing right here is actually my community, which I host on circle.so. It's a community platform that a lot of creators use to create community components of courses they might be running, to create communities and enthusiast groups, fan groups, hobby groups, whatever it might be. It's what I've chosen to use for my community. It's the best fit for me. And so I'm going to walk you through how I apply this framework to my own community within Circle. So here's how it works. I think about a framework called the commitment curve. Now, if you have not heard of the commitment curve before, I encourage you to Google community commitment curve and you'll find lots and lots of resources about it. But essentially what it dictates or what it is teaching you how to do is create a journey for your members from discovering your community and then over time to actually starting to join and then onboard, then regularly engage. And then for a select few, they might even elect to become leaders in that community. So the commitment curve is a way of thinking about creating that experience for people so that you can create a scalable community strategy. So the commitment curve and how it applies to communities online. So when I'm thinking about community building for my community, I know that one of the most important parts of the member journey is that join to onboarding process. So how I do that within Circle, I make sure that whenever someone joins my community, they go straight into this welcome space here. So what this welcome space allows people to do is orient to what it is they're about to walk into. So that includes, you know, what is our purpose here? What are the key features? So I actually have recorded a video via Loom to introduce people to how to actually orient themselves to the community. And then there is a really clear checklist here that actually walks people through the very easy step-by-step pieces of the onboarding process. So they start by introducing themselves, then they add any events to their calendars, then they're reading the community guidelines, then they're reviewing my coaching philosophy, etc., etc. And what this is doing over time is going from easy small asks to a little bit harder, a little bit bigger asks over time. So introducing yourself, everybody likes introducing themselves in a community. It's why for years now, forums have often had intro threads, newbie areas, things like that. So this is a really easy ask to ask somebody to introduce themselves. Then adding the course events to your calendar, it's a little bit of a nitpicky task. It's a little bit annoying, if I'm being totally honest with you. And so it's still really easy though. So we ask people to do that second, after they've gotten this quick win of introducing themselves and seeing who else is in the community. Then we have them read the community guidelines. That can be pretty boring and dry. And then my coaching philosophy, so that they really understand the culture, the norms of the space, and what to expect from me, the leader of this community. And then finally, you're gonna see this, in our case, we have an onboarding survey that we send out to folks. So this is gonna be the biggest ask of all during this onboarding phase, is filling out this survey. So it's gonna ask them about 10 different questions about where they're at today, what their goals are, and then how I can best help them as they're going throughout their community journey. And this is one of the really cool things is that, yeah, they've done a lot of really nitpicky things. So how can we reward them for that so that they feel like they're making progress through that commitment curve journey? Well, this is how I have this set up. So I actually have an Airtable form embedded within my Circle post here, and they fill out really quickly, first name, last name, email, and then all of the tasks that they've completed. This is all honor system, okay? I do check in on this, but they have to tell me that they've done all of these things, and then they hit submit. And what I have set up on the back end, and I'm not gonna show you this here because it's way too detailed, but what I have set up on the back end is actually a Zapier automation, where when they fill out this Airtable, it sends them a, through Zapier, it sends them a badge within Circle. So they actually get tagged as a community onboarding all-star. So that actually goes on their profile. So you're going to see these badges, for instance, when you go into spaces like this one. This is a badge right here, okay? So that is all just the welcome area, and I haven't actually separated out because I know that onboarding can be such a overwhelming part of a journey for folks. The other thing that I have set up in here that I think is really, really important is I've actually thought through the ways in which Circle is sending out emails to members. So how this works is you go into your backend of Circle, then you go into onboarding. Of course, it has an onboarding section, and then you can actually customize the invite emails that go out. You can customize the onboarding pop-up. So as soon as somebody signs up, a pop-up will show up on their screen telling them what to do first, and then you can actually set up an email that gets sent out after account setup that gives them one clear call to action. So the important thing to take away here is that every single communication that you have during this onboarding phase should have a very, very clear call to action. So for this one, it's accept your invitation, and that will have you join. For this one, once they finally get in, they see the ways that they can get involved. It sends them right to that onboarding checklist, as I just showed you. And then once they go back and check their email later on, they can see that there is this onboarding email and they get reminded again to complete the checklist, because I know a lot of folks don't complete it in one go. So for you, this might be, you know, sending people to introduce themselves. You could slow down onboarding, not have it as robust as mine for this paid program that I run, and just make it one piece at a time. What are the clear, simple calls to action that you can be laddering people up to over time inside of your community? Now, once people are onboarded, oftentimes what happens is we think so much about onboarding and then we forget about the other pieces of engagement. So once you move from onboarding, the big question becomes, okay, we're onboarded, like, what do we do now? How do I stay involved? What is a member supposed to do here? What are the norms? What's going to be celebrated and appreciated? And so one of the ways that I have thought about doing this in my community is setting up a weekly cadence of work out loud posts. So this can be anything for you. It could be a weekly cadence of, you know, sharing your goals. It can be sharing your feelings. It can be sharing the project that you're working on, whatever it might be, something that is a regular cadence, something they can count on, a ritual that they can participate in each week. So what I have done here to make sure that this is actually engaging and not just, you know, going out to crickets, is I actually have a set up an announcement space here, and I've asked everyone to keep their notifications on for this space, keep their emails on for this space. So I actually don't even use email for my community members anymore, because I send out all the emails to my community members through the announcement posts. And these remind people to fill out those workout louds. It gives people really important course information. It might remind people to finish a module, whatever that might be. This is actually how I communicate most with my members. And so I went through in this onboarding, once you go through that checklist, one of the things on the checklist is actually to make sure that inside of the announcements area, you have enabled emails for announcements. So I let them know that if they don't do that, they're really, really missing out. And of course, you might miss some folks that way, but it makes sure that people are opting in to communication with you and they're not gonna get annoyed with you over time, okay? And if they are, they can always change their settings. All right, so this is just the very beginning of what you can do with Circle, what you could do with Zapier, Airtable, all these things within your tech stack that you might be curious to play around with. So if you have other questions about how to create unique and memorable community experiences with the technology that you have at your hands, I'm your girl, I got you. So let me know how else I can help you, and enjoy building your community.